Welcome to Movie Talkies, Vidya.
Thank you.
You are coming back with Kahani 2 after 4 long years. How does it feel?
It feels wonderful, yeah. Because Kahani was so loved. And people kept saying, when are you all making Kahani 2? And we couldn't find the right idea for a sequel to Kahani 2. But I'm glad Shujoy found a story that he thought was worthy of taking the franchise forward. I heard the story and I said, if there was ever a Kahani 2, it had to be this one. You know, and people have loved the trailer, so that's very, very encouraging.
So were you stumped after getting the narration?
No, I wasn't stumped, but I must say that it's a really well-written script and screenplay, so you know. And I think that is Shujoy's forte. So I was like, oh my God, this is not something I'd expected. He narrated an idea to me, you know, immediately after Kahani. But at that time, baat bani nahi. And then when he came back with a full-fledged script last year, I was like, oh my God, I didn't see this coming.
Okay. So did you give any inputs?
I think when you're working on a film, invariably those inputs happen. But it's very difficult to say, oh, I gave this input in this scene or I changed this line. Because that's a...
Very impromptu.
Yeah, and it's set. Filmmaking is a collaborative process, you know. Sometimes it's an assistant who's suggesting something. Sometimes it's a costume assistant. Sometimes it's the art director. Everyone is pooling resources to tell a story in the best possible manner. So, of course, I give my inputs. But... I think in Shujoy's case, the script is half the work done. So when you reach on set, you really have to put only 50% of the effort into your performance because it's all there in the script.
So you are playing Vidya Sinha and Durga Rani Singh. How did you prepare for your roles? And is it difficult to portray two different characters in the same film?
You know, that's a very interesting and tricky question because I don't want to give away too much about the film. So, but I will say this, that, you know, I love complicated people, especially as characters whom I have to live. And Durga Rani Singh is unseemingly complicated. She seems quite simple, ordinary, regular, nondescript. She wants to be invisible. You know, she's very ordinary. But she's got a very sharp and intelligent mind, obviously. She knows what's happening all around her. And something happens in her life that makes her, you know, makes her take charge of her life in a way that you wouldn't have expected of her. Whereas Vidya Sinha is very different from Durga Rani Singh. One is a mother, one is a murderer, or maybe... one is a mother and murderer and one is neither. I don't know.
You're not giving away anything.
You have to reach the theatres on the 2nd of December.
How did you prepare for both these characters?
I think it's just reading the script and having chats with Shujoy, working on the look, which is very, very crucial. So, you know, I have my team who's been working with me forever. Shreyas Mathre, who does the makeup. Shalaka More, who does my hair. And the costume designer on the film was Darshan. Jalan. So all these people pooled in resources, and we had a prosthetic makeup artist, Simone, who came down from Italy for special parts in the film. So I think the look is very, very crucial because I'm one person, you know, and I can easily look like myself in every character. So to distinguish every character, if you're able to do something different and create a new person, it's really very helpful in storytelling. So, you know, all these people put in their resources and then I try and create something out of that. So, that was really the preparation as far as this film goes.
So, there was a lot of conjecture in between that all's not well between you and Shujoy. Obviously, you did
all
teen
was not
after
well.
That. Yeah. So, what exactly happened?
No, we didn't speak to each other for 1.5 years, you know. I don't know what happened. I was supposed to do a film called Durga Rani Singh with him. And I had some health issues, so I had to opt out of the film. And he got upset because he felt I opted out of his film and not Hamari Adhuri Kahani. You know, it's just that his film, he couldn't wait whereas Hamari Adhuri Kahani was getting pushed by 6 months. Therefore, I ended up doing that film. But, you know, sometimes when things are not working out the way you want them to, you become overly sensitive to things. So I think he was rightfully angry at that time. I was also very awkward about having walked out of the film. So I think it, for 1.5 years, we just didn't speak to each other. Then one day I just bumped into him at a coffee shop and the ice was broken and we were back to being. And then I did Teen and I did Kahani 2.
So did you patch up just for Kahani 2?
No. I didn't even know that. Actually, that's not a bad idea. But I didn't know Kahani 2 was, you know, that he had written Kahani 2 or that he had any plans of making the film. I didn't know what was happening in his life at all.
So we are very glad that you both came together because there can't be a Kahani 2 without Vidya Balan.
Oh, thank you.
Okay, so Kahani blew everybody's mind.
Yeah.
Okay, so do you think that there's a lot of responsibility on you to now deliver again? And are you feeling the pressure?
No, I'm not feeling the pressure. Because, you know, if we had felt the pressure, we couldn't have told the story. So actually, it's very helpful that Kahani 2 is not a sequel. Maybe we would have felt the pressure then. Maybe we would have felt the pressure if the film was being made immediately after Kahani. But now there's 4.5 years in between the two films. And audiences have liked the trailer. So they've bought into this story. Now I just hope they like the film.
So you were lying about your pregnancy in the first film. Here, probably you are lying about your identity. I'm just assuming. What does Vidya Balan lie about in real life?
That's a tricky question now. I could... Actually, I don't lie all that much. I used to lie very easily until, I think, 2-3 years ago.
What changed? Your marriage?
I think marriage. Because in a marriage, you can't really lie, you know. Also, previously, I would get late. I would reach places late and I would make up an excuse and say there was traffic and there was this and that. Now I'm never late. Never say never, but I'm rarely late anymore. So I think there's no reason for me to lie. When I don't like a script, I'm upfront and I tell people. When I don't want to go for an event also, I'm upfront. But sometimes, I think, sometimes I lie when I don't want to go for a party. I'm not a party person at all.
Okay. So you have a diary in the film. Do you maintain a diary in real life?
Yes, I do. But you'll find nothing in it.
So what's the point?
Only blank pages. I have invisible ink.
So what do you write in that invisible ink?
Things that you're not supposed to read, so I can't tell you.
So sad. How was it working with Arjun Rampal? This is the first time you're working
with him. It was fun. He's easy. He's charming. He laughs a lot and he's a good actor. It was just easy breezy, yeah.
It is said that Sujoy got inspired by Feluda. Did you get a chance to go through it for Kahani? To convert Kahani into a franchise?
No, I'm not aware of that inspiration, though I've read Feluda. But I didn't know. Really?
I just read it in Wikipedia.
Okay. I wasn't aware of that, so I was a bit taken aback.
See, that's a bit of a trivia for you.
But Wikipedia is not to be trusted.
Yeah,
I tell you on record that my birth date is wrong, my place of birth is wrong, and there are a few other details that are wrong in Wikipedia. I've been trying to tell them that this is wrong information, but they won't accept it from me. So I don't know who they're going to accept it from.
Why?
About myself. I don't know. please tell Wikipedia, my birth date is the 1st of Jan 79.
All right.
It says 78.
Oh.
And it says I was born in Kerala. I was born in Chembur, Mumbai.
Correct. So they say it's very difficult to shoot with kids. How was your experience working with Naisha?
It was not at all difficult to shoot with Naisha. She's a lovely child. Children are lovely. But she's just, you know, she's a batuni. She would keep talking to everyone on set. She was talking 19 to the dozen. And she's so cute and she's a fabulous actor. I actually fell in love with that kid during the shoot.
So from a regular Chembur girl to a TV actress and now you are this big Bollywood star, how has life changed for you?
A lot, many more people know me. You know, and fame is wonderful. It earns me a lot of privileges and luxuries and love, most importantly. And at the same time, you know, there are some things you have to let go of, like your privacy. But I don't think it's a big price.
All right. So you're happy
where
you are.
This is where I wanted to be and this is where I am. I couldn't have asked for more.
So you've played real life characters on screen and you've played fictional characters. Which one is more difficult to portray? Because for fictional, you obviously don't have a reference point.
Yeah, but you know, when you're doing a biopic, for example, it's a bit tricky because people know the person. So you have to be very careful about not hurting sensitivities, people's sentiments. About, you know, you're a different person, so you'll never be that person. But pick up mannerisms that could be. So I try.
So which one do you find more difficult?
Doing a real life character. Yeah.
Okay. Arjun said that his last release, Rock On 2, got affected because of demonetization.
Right.
Are you worried about Kahani's fate?
No, because I think it is true that, you know, films have gotten affected by demonetization because people didn't have money in their pockets. But having said that, I think har film ki kismat hoti hai. And I really, really believe in that. I'm not being a fatalist when I say that. But I really believe that if a film is meant to work. Kahani opened at 1 crore when it did. And then it went on to do almost 100 crores worldwide. You know, so
you're really confident about the project.
Yeah, as in I'm confident about the film, of course. But more importantly, I think every film has a fate. So one has to just wait and watch.
So your last few releases did not work at the box office. How did it affect you and how do you deal with failures?
You know, I cry, I get angry, I want to blame someone, I want to blame myself. I'm irritable, I don't want to step out of the house. I vent with Siddharth and with my family. I'm constantly telling them how I'm feeling. But that helps me let go so I can move on. It affects me. It disappoints me. It breaks my heart. But you have to move on.
I have a Kahani quiz for you. So what is your all-time favorite Kahani?
What is my all-time favorite Kahani? That you tell kids or just any Kahani?
Any. All through your life, you may have read,
you know,
some story.
I read about how, not read about, I met this Australian lady who was married to this man for 30 long years. And suddenly, when she was passing through some desert in the Middle East, she saw someone doing the azan and she felt a calling. So she found out more about what that person was doing and then she converted to Islam. And then she fell in love with a Sufi musician. He didn't understand her language, she didn't understand his. But what a love story. I can never forget this story.
Okay. So a Kahani that inspires you?
The story of anyone who's managed to overcome hurdles, to succeed, to live life on their own terms, inspires me.
So the weirdest Kahani you've heard about yourself?
Oh my God. That the weirdest Kahani that I've heard about myself is, I think it's got to be that pregnancy room. Every month they can't get me pregnant. It's humanly impossible.
A Kahani, a false Kahani, which you wish was true about you.
It's not yet a Kahani, but we can start it right here that I'm doing a Woody Allen film.
So you want to spread it yourself?
Yeah.
Okay. A Kahani you would want to be a part of?
Any Woody Allen film.
One Bollywood Kahani you regret doing?
No regrets at all. But I wish I'd done differently. I think Hey Baby and Kismat Connection.
Okay. So tell our audiences quickly why they should go and watch Kahani 2.
Did you like Kahani? I'm sure you did. And if you like Kahani, this is Kahani 2, so you like it doubly. Please go and watch Kahani 2. On the 2nd of December in theatres near you. See you, love you, God bless you. And I'm a poet and I didn't know it.
It was great talking to you, Vidya, and I wish you all the very best for Kahani.
Thank you, Pankhuri.
Thank you.